play Careless Whisper for the students who were in a rehearsal room at Ramsey Hall at UCL, practicing their version of it earlier this week. Sounded great to me. We'll come rushing back in just a moment. This is BBC Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker, 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Harvey Cook. The chair of the Conservative Party, Nazim Zahawi, has confirmed the government is looking at using the armed forces to reduce the impact of strikes. He said that could include filling roles in border security, the NHS and driving ambulances. Nurses in parts of England, Wales and Northern Ireland are due to walk out on the 15th and 20th of December in a dispute about pay. Mr Zahawi told the BBC's Sunday with Laura Koonsberg programme that the unions should reconsider their industrial action.
It's unfair, in my view, for the unions to really damage people's and disrupt people's lives and livelihoods at a time at Christmas. And they should really rethink and they should reflect on this.
The head of the police watchdog in England and Wales has been forced to step down after he became the subject of a police investigation. The Home Secretary, Suella Braverman, says she asked Michael Lockwood to leave the independent office for police conduct because of an historic allegation. The boss of one of the world's biggest energy firms says it will take years for prices to return to where they were before the war in Ukraine. Francesco Seracci, who runs Enel, says the only way to bring down costs is investing in renewable power sources. England are getting ready for their last 16 match against Senegal at the Football World Cup. The game kicks off in Qatar at 7 this evening. Victory for Gareth Southgate's side would see them through to a third consecutive quarter-final at a major tournament. These two England fans in Doha are confident they'll be able to make it through.
It's going to be a tough game tonight, but we don't want to leave it to the last minute like Colombia last time out. We need a nice early goal, settle the nerves, and I think we'll be fine tonight.
And I think if Harry Kane finds his sort of scoring touch, that's what England need now. I think it'll be a good win for England tonight. I think 2-0, Harry Kane get on the score sheet.
In Senegal, our West Africa correspondent Mwaeni Jones has been looking at the history of the beautiful game in the country.
This is a nation obsessed with football. Every evening, young men pour onto the capital's streets and its famous beachfront to play the beautiful game. Large screens have been set up across town and more viewing areas for fans are being built ahead of tonight's match. But even though some of the squad plays in British clubs, many here expect that defeating England will be challenging.
People are being moved from their homes on the Indonesian island of Java after a volcano erupted. Mount Sumeru spewed clouds of hot ash a mile into the sky and sent lava flowing down its slopes. The Royal Navy has come to the aid of staff at the world's most remote post office in Antarctica. Sailors and Royal Marines from HMS Protector have spent 2 days helping the four British women who run the Port Lockroy scientific base dig it out after it was buried in up to 4 metres of snow. Well, not quite so wintry here, mostly cloudy, with some showers moving into northeast England and eastern Scotland through the day. And that's the BBC News at 10:03.
Well, thank you very much. Welcome back. It's Love Songs. Second hour.
Steve Wright's Sunday Love Songs.